Greetings, I'm Caffeine Rage, and once again, I'm joined by...
Gaming Psychologist.
As we ruin his marriage and play Terraria all at the same time.
All of that stuff, though, is not recorded.
Well, unfortunately.
Unfortunately. It would be great for entertaining purposes.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I stopped my recording. I think you stopped yours as well, but... Yeah, he got in trouble.
Yeah.
you care to let people know?
I have too many man crushes, among other things. Being a big dummy is another thing. But that's okay.
Having man crushes is one thing. Voicing them around your wife is another.
She's heard them all, I think. she gave me dirty looks. Uh-oh. All of my man crushes. Yeah.
If you list them out, do you need someone to basically make a scroll and have it just go out across the room? And I think I have a train coming.
Choo-choo.
So I'm going to be quiet for a little bit.
Train keeps it rolling right on time. I like Twains.
I do too when they don't interrupt recording.
Oh no, I accidentally destroyed a torch. Go back up there, little torch. So what are we going to do in this episode? You were about to tell me something about columns, but you said we should record.
Yeah, I'm trying to wait for the train to go by. It's like in the distance, and I hear the whistle.
Okay. Well, while you do that...
The columns is something that we can make later on.
Oh, okay.
Actually, hang on. We may be able to make it now. I'm going to go double-check the wiki while I wait for the train to go by.
Okay, you do that. I'm going to... I don't know, go dig a hole or something.
There's a shock. No, actually, we can make it now. I just need to... move out of the... You know... You're going to live with the ugly ziggurat.
Hey, you're calling my ziggurat ugly. That's not nice.
Okay, the stone ziggurat.
The less than appealing ziggurat.
I'm just happy with how my house turned out. And I think the train was actually on the other side of the river, so I was just hearing it in the distance.
Your house looks really nice for people watching on mine. I think I came over here last episode, but let's just take a tour. And here we have the main foyer. We take the stairs up to the second floor. This is a small dining area. And over here we have the study with the workbench.
And well, I was trying to break up, I just didn't want the same damn table in all the rooms.
And if we go upstairs to the attic, for some reason, there's a fireplace up here, but it looks nice and cozy.
It's the lounge. And plus, I didn't want to waste a ton more space for another stairwell.
And hidden behind the stairs is the cupboard where Harry Potter shall live. With a desk and the chair.
Which is more than what he deserves.
Oh, that's harsh. I was going to say it's more than what he had, but... Whatever works.
I think this train's coming here at like 5 miles an hour because I keep hearing the whistle. Oh, there it is.
Oh, I just got a message from GoShark. He said he wanted to thank me and curse me for more mobile game recommendations from the last podcast episode. Or the last couple. Apparently, he's now playing Skyforce Unite. Which, I have played that a bit this week. Fun. Obviously, we'll talk about that more on the podcast, as well as my woes with Clash Royale. Got a lot of woes this week.
Whoa. Yeah, I can hear the train going by at a very slow speed. I'm going to drop the new... workstation over here just because there's not a lot of room.
Not sure why I'm digging this out, but I am. Dig, 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 dig.
Yeah, I just dropped a couple of new workstations in the house. But now we are able to make some new things with the sawmill.
Ooh, fancy. Where's the sawmill?
In the house over here. There's really no place to put it over there.
Yeah, we're out of space over there.
But what you're talking about is wooden beams. Just wood to make wooden beams, and I'll show them to you.
Banquet table. That's fancy. Bar stool. Loom used for crafting cloth. Oh, hey, cool.
Yeah, that's what's used. Actually, hang on. As we get the rain, yes, we're still building a bit.
Item frame. What is that? Weapon rack.
You can frame an item to use as decoration.
Ah, I gotcha. Keg. That's what I'm talking about. Let's brew some ale.
You lush. We don't need another drunk episode yet.
Sure we do. We need all the drunk episodes. Okay, so how did you make the beam?
Bath just thing. Wood.
Wood dresser, wood table, mannequin. Womannequin, I like that.
Womannequin.
Womannequin.
Do you have any cobwebs? Because we're a few short.
No. I thought we had a whole bunch of cobwebs, though. Or did you go get them all out of the chest?
Oh, I got some. Unless they're split over here. Okay, there's some more. Yeah, they were split between, like, three different chests.
What are you making?
You'll see.
Also, I couldn't build any beams. Do I not have enough wood in my inventory?
It's literally just one wood.
And you build it at the sawmill?
Yeah.
I must be blind then. Let's see. Oh, there it is. Yep, I'm blind. Excellent. Oh, bed.
Yes, I'm redecorating.
Fancy.
That allows us to set our spawn point.
Spawn point set. I now will spawn in your bed. How do you like to sound that, Rage?
Well, I think you're going to get in trouble with your wife again.
Probably. Cool. I'm going to go get some more wood now, though, and see what I can make.
Yeah, I didn't realize that. Well, I forgot that we had extra chain, which is what we were missing before with this.
What was it that you were talking about making with the bridge?
I wanted to do like sort of a covered bridge, but it's going to take some more material.
What kind of material?
Well, it's going to require another NPC for how I want to do it.
Ah, I see. Well, hopefully we got some of those incoming. Will they spawn with us here, or do we need to leave and then come back?
I'm actually not sure about that. But I've made us a proper bedroom now.
Oh, you put a
fancy
little cabinet in there and everything.
Yeah.
Very fancy. I approve. You should come be my interior decorator.
I'm not falling for that one.
Die, zombie, die. Why are you chipping away at my bridge? Is that a dead goldfish? Oh, nice, you can put some support beams on it.
Yep, ran out. I only made a few. I wanted to see how it looked before committing a lot of wood to it.
That's what she said.
Yeah, I could probably just make a soundboard of you saying that.
Probably.
I mean, I did that for you whenever you couldn't talk for a while.
Did you really?
Yeah, you don't remember that?
No, I'm drawing a blank. I thought you made a joke that you were going to do it, but you actually did it?
Yeah, I sent you like 5 MP3s.
Oh, that's right. That's right. I remember now.
And what one was that?
That's what she said. I mean, really, that's all you need.
Well, this isn't exact, but I think it looks better with the support beams, with the wooden support beams, I should say.
I agree. Tearing up the rope, man. Can you stand on top of wooden beams or build stuff on, like, directly on top of them?
You could stand you could walk right past them. The limitation is that they're actually, there's three essentially layers going on with Terraria. You have the background layer, the wall layer, you have the furniture layer, then you have the player layer.
Right.
Wooden beams are on the furniture layer. So you saw me put some in here.
Right.
That's what's going on, is that I couldn't put them going up the entire house. Because they would interfere with the furniture. So, like, I couldn't put them right where I'm standing.
I got you.
Give Harry Potter some light over his little crappy desk.
How nice of you. I'm sure he appreciates it.
Okay, well, I think I'm going to go store stuff, and then maybe we should actually go do something interesting outside of just building.
Nah, this is interesting. Everyone's on the edge of their seats with how interesting this has been. Aren't you, audience?
I'll just wait till I start building the basement.
Is it a creepy basement?
I could make a creepy basement if I really wanted to.
Yeah. I like these beams. They're going to change everything. Going to revolutionize the building industry.
Yeah, but we can't let the Russians know about our beam technology.
Nope. Can't do that.
Otherwise, there'll be a beam race. We can't let there be a beam gap.
I want to say bean. I want there to be a bean race and a bean gap.
You know, that kind of reminds me of this terrible, terrible joke, so I must share it.
All right. Terrible joke away.
Well, terribly racist joke, but it's about my own ethnicity, so I think I'm allowed to say it.
Okay.
How many potatoes does it take to kill an Irishman?
I don't know how many.
Zero.
Because the Irish potato famine.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
I mean, it took almost that many to kill Matt Damon.
Martian joke. Hilarious.
Okay, well, I've cleared out my inventory and I think I'm done building for a while, so shall we go cause trouble?
Sure.
You're compensating, aren't you? You do realize that blocks movement, though, right?
Yes, it does. You can go ahead and start tearing it down.
Your job.
What did you say?
That is your job.
Oh, tearing it down. Fair enough.
Yeah, so I'm looking at the map and thinking that maybe we should attempt the corruption at some point soon.
Okay.
Actually, I need to check something on our supplies before we head out.
I think I just made a horrible mistake. I accidentally destroyed the block. Oh no, okay, I can put it back. I accidentally destroyed the block that the rope was resting on.
It'd be hilarious if it just all falls down, but it doesn't.
That would be pretty funny, I'd have to say. I'm gonna build my own personal sky house with blackjack and hookers.
On second thought, forget the sky house. Okay. Do you happen to know where the lenses are hidden? Oh, never mind, there they are.
I'm glad you found them because I was gonna say no. I don't know where they were hidden. Dang it.
Okay, so let's go ahead and
Ready to go on an adventure?
yeah, do you want to join me?
Yep, let's go on an adventure. Where are we going?
Unfortunately, it's also going to be night soon, but going to attempt the corruption since we have grappling hooks now and some better armor.
You run. You're faster than me. You can sprint. There's a torch all the way up here? Did you do that?
Yeah.
Alright, so the corruption.
Yeah, and we're going down. Oh, I hear a worm coming. We may be here a bit early, but there's also two of us, so. That's me you're shooting.
Sorry.
Okay, this one's a dead end.
Oh, hey,
Quite
doting
literally for
psychologists
someone.
fell to their death. I guess I died here a long time ago. Can we just dig?
Not with our level of pickaxes. We need a NPC to be able to do it without the pickaxe upgrade.
Ah, I see.
Should I spoil what I'm wanting to do here?
Is there a boss that you're wanting to fight?
Well, I'm here to craft an item to summon a boss.
Whoops, I fell down and hurt myself. Oh no, I fell down to my death.
Well, technically, you did hurt yourself again.
That is very true. I did hurt myself again. I dropped an entire gold if you want to go get it.
Oh, yes, I do.
I'm not gonna go back down in the hole. I would rather not die again. At least by falling to my death. Plus, I've got.
Well, here's the thing is that you could use your double jump to avoid fall damage.
That's true. I did not think about that. And I hadn't used my double jump. I was grappling, using the grappling hook to climb out. Did you keep going to the left? I guess.
Oh, I went west. To get the gold first.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think we're at the point now where we could do deal with the corruption. It's still a bit of a challenge. Well, of course, gravity's more of a challenge for you, but
gravity is definitely a challenge for me. All right, have you been down here? Oh, hey.
Oh.
Nice shot. You lit him on fire. What are these things called? Eater of Souls.
Another dead end.
Okay. Glad I didn't jump down. Otherwise, I'd probably have just fallen back down to my death. Come on, Eater of Souls. My aim is bad, and I should feel bad.
I just finished him off with a yo-yo.
He should feel bad for that, too.
But this is why I love the Flaricon.
Anything down there?
Yeah, come down. Now, unfortunately, we can't make too much of a use of this place yet. We're really here to do crafting on these altars.
Okay.
And we're done.
What did you make?
Well, we have plenty of time in the episode, but we need to wait for nighttime to do what I have planned. Well, actually, how much explosive do you have on you?
None, I don't think.
Okay, let's see if I have enough.
No, I've got no explosives on me.
You may want to stay over there.
Nope. Here comes a soul leader.
Whoops. Wasted some dynamite.
I'll protect you.
As it almost knocks me back into the dynamite.
Oh, shoot.
Fire in the hole!
No. All right, that works.
Okay.
A horrible chill goes down your spine. Smashing something.
Yeah, I'm gonna smash two of these orbs. We do not want to smash a third right now.
Okay.
Trust me on that.
I trust you. What does smashing two of them do? Ah, crap. Get away from me.
Well, we also get loot from these, and I grabbed the gun from it.
Screams echo around you. Tony the Arms Dealer has arrived.
Yeah, that's actually what triggered whenever I smashed the first one is that I got a gun.
Fancy.
So let's teleport out of here.
Okay.
So we have a new merchant.
Oh, hey look. Keep your hands off my gun, buddy. He says. What do we got? Flintlock pistol.
Where did he...
Mini shot?
I didn't set my spawn over here.
And a musket
ball. The musket ball's ammo. The mini shark is essentially a mini gun.
Half shark, half gun. Completely awesome. So So the flintlock pistol does as much damage as the tungsten bow.
Things are about to get crazy.
What happened? What's happening?
Random event.
The blood moon is rising.
Yeah. Remember how we were how I was talking about how enemies normally don't spawn near friendly NPCs?
Yeah.
That kind of changes with the blood moon.
Okay. Oh, hey, and they got in the house.
Yeah, that's something else is that they learned to open doors.
During the blood moon?
Yep.
So we should just hide in our house tonight?
Well, they're not terribly difficult. It's more of an annoyance.
Blood zombie.
And they could overwhelm us, so, you know, don't knock them into one another. I mean, if we really wanted to, we could barricade, but it's mostly the demon eyes that are going to be a problem.
You defeated the 50th demon eye. So are all of our NPC buddies going to die?
No, they can fight back.
Oh, he's throwing bombs.
Thankfully, they don't destroy the tiles. They're essentially grenades.
Oh, okay. What is that thing? The flying squishy thing.
I think that's a dripper.
Did you buy a gun?
No, the gun I got from the orb.
Oh, okay.
I held on. I just grabbed it, so. Because that's what... actually, that's what triggered the demolition... Or not the demolition, but the gun merchant to show up. Was having a gun in one of our inventory. And also, the orb breaking is one of the requirements for the Blood Moon to start. I didn't think we had the others yet.
What are the other requirements?
I know it's a certain health threshold, and I guess we're past it.
I have 160 health.
I have 140, so that means I get the next life orb or life crystal. But yeah, I guess maybe it combines our health to figure that out. Because I thought it was like 180. So I was going to do an event tonight, but a different event popped up. So yeah.
Yeah, this isn't too bad. It's kind of like scary looking, but.
It's a lot scarier if we were less prepared. But trust me, there's much worse out there. But yeah, I definitely like the guns over the bow and arrow.
Less travel time?
Less travel time and more damage.
Well, the bow does... I've got a tungsten bow. It does 10 damage, which is what the pistol did.
The musket I got is 32 damage.
Oh, well, the pistol that I can buy from Dude is the same. It does the same damage as my bow. Actually, less.
Remember, it also combines ammo as well, and I don't think the musket balls is... actually, the musket balls are more damage, so I just got a huge range damage to increase. And I didn't realize it was that big.
Yeah, I think arrows are 6 damage or 5 damage.
Also got something else from the second orb, but I'm looking...
7 damage. So the flintlock pistol would do 2 more damage than my tungsten bow.
Yeah, let me see. There's what the other thing I got was. It is a vial thorn.
What is that?
Here, I'll show you. Oh!
A meteorite has landed. Oh, what is that?
This is the Vial Thorn. Do you want it?
What does that do?
It's a magic item that, it creates a thorn that kind of just is that.
That's cool.
It's not a huge amount of damage, but it's it kind of traps them. But okay, the meteorite. is something else that triggers from the shadow orbs. It's a sort of a mid-range ore. It's a meteor falling down to the sky from the sky somewhere around us. I have no idea where just yet. We would have to go hunting for it.
Does it stay during the daylight?
Yeah, it stays.
Okay, so we can just go.
It's a permanent thing until we mine it. Now the thing is that it's dangerous to mine because first of all, you can't touch it because it deals fire damage to you, so you have to watch mining it, and also it spawns enemies around it, so you have to have somebody watch your back. And I would ask, do you want to mine or watch my back whenever we're mining it? But I think I know the answer to that already.
You are correct. I definitely want to go mine the meteor.
Yeah, but we have to find it first. And we have at least one in the world. Another one may spawn in the next night or two because we broke two orbs. But the meteor makes fun things.
Nope, I took fall damage.
Yeah, and I'm more just waiting for the blood moon to wrap up. Well, should we just go ahead and start wrapping things up and get our long spiel out of the way and then just finish up there?
Yeah, it'll take us 10 minutes to finish up. Or to wrap up. What is that?
A bride.
A bride?
A wedding dress and veil. And veil. Do you want them? Do you want to dress up as a pretty bride?
Yeah, but sure, but why? She wasn't
a
zombie.
It's a cosmetic thing.
Yeah, but she wasn't a zombie.
Yes, she was.
Oh, she was?
Yeah, and there's actually a groom that spawns that has a top hat.
Awesome. Ow. Blood zombies. But yeah, I wrapped up first last time, so Rage, where can they find you?
Well, assuming they're not watching me on watching this on my channel, they can find me at Gaming with Caffeine Rage on YouTube or on Twitter if you want to see me rant and occasionally post interesting things at Gaming with CR.
Very occasionally. Silence? Did I strike a nerve?
Well, I was more watching where I was shooting and seeing if there was anything else to shoot.
I gotcha.
Well, hey, I think I'm a good shot with the musket. What can I say?
Does the musket travel in a straight line or does it arc?
It's a pretty straight line. Okay. If it has any arc to it, I can't notice it.
Well, you can find me on YouTube at Gaming Psychologist. You can find me on Twitter at JMA4707. You can find me on Twitch at JArthur4707. I have a smattering of different YouTube videos on my channel. And of course, you can find us every week on Friday at 12 or 12:01 if Rage is annoying me on the Video Game Logic Podcast.
You know, that's the only reason why I do that, right?
I know. I've known that for some time. We've even talked about it a couple of times now, I think.
Yes, and it just is too funny for me not to do it anymore.
Yeah, because you're a butthead. So basically we're
is it going to stop your man crush on me?
No, it's not.
I wonder who has the bigger man crush, you or Biff?
Definitely Biff.
Yeah, Biff has made fan art.
Oh. Achievement unlocked, Bloodbath. Fancy.
Well, yeah, we'll say bye-bye and we'll get out of here.
Yep, since we made it through the Blue Moon, or not Blue Moon, the Blood Moon. Until next time, bye-bye now.
See you then.